this scenario, this story, is the nightmare scenario for any parent, for anyone really. Is that what attracted you to really explore the kind of the dark side?
What attracted me is that it was the exploration of how those characters were reacting toward that kind of strong violence, and the way they were spreading violence themselves after. It was, for me, a very powerful story, and very dark, but seeing sad, accurate things about North America today.
Well, I was going to say, I mean, there's an obvious sort of parallel to the political situation, since
that, I think those the best stories are always like this. I think you can read them in different ways. There's of course strong parallel that you can do if you change a character for countries, and then you have a total different reading of the movie, and that attracted me a lot. Yeah, I think it's quite accurate.
Yeah. Because I mean, both leads, especially, you know, Gyllenhaal and Jackman's characters, they've got a lot of anger in them, as well as, you know, Jackman in particular is suffering a lot in the absence of his daughter. But there's a kind of pent up rage beneath the surface of both.
But because it's when you as a human being, when you're put into you are confronted to such violent events, I mean trauma, I mean you lose control, and you are the forces inside you are not the best part of yourself that is coming out. So it's just that, and the story is taking place in a week following those the disappearance of the kids. So I mean it's like just a elevator to hell. I mean it's like there's no space to sleep, there's no space to it's just a strong, it's such a strong emotional impact on the character that they are themselves beginning to go in a violent mode. It's like the exploration of that that ride is what attracted me to the story.
Yeah, the sort of pressure cooker atmosphere.
Yeah.
And there's also a kind of a religious element going on, because both characters have a very strong sort of religious connection. Jackman's character, obviously, when we first hear his voice, it's to say a prayer. And Gyllenhaal has, I mean, he has the crucifix or the cross tattooed on his hand. Are those angelic symbols that he has on his knuckles as well?
Yeah.
So where did that come in?
The thing is that about the tattoos, it was things that were brought by Jake from the study we made together of the character. I mean, he had that. I wanted the character to be more defined. I wanted to create a real human being in front of the camera. And Jake and I and Aaron Grzegorzewski, the screenwriter, brainstormed together to try to create, to go out of the cliche and create a unique detective. Because a detective in cinema, we saw 10,000, a million of detectives before. So we were trying to create something original as much as possible. And Jake, I love when for the audience you can guess, you can feel the past of a character without explanation, and that was the direction we were going for. What was the other question?
Oh, just about the religious.
Oh yes, sorry. So, but about the Keller Dover, his relationship with the religion, it was something that was present in the script. The character was listening to tapes in his car. But I felt that I changed that a bit, because I said to myself, the idea was to, it was necessary to make the movie according to me, to be close to the father, to be more intimate with him. And one of the most intimate thing that you can do as a human being is when you pray. Whatever is your religion, I mean, the relationship you have with your own God is something that is so intimate. And I brought the idea of hearing Keller Dover's praying in a different way as the movie is moving forward, as the story is moving forward. And it will allow us to be in contact with his intimate inner world.